everybody, we're gonna do Taurus. Ten of Pentacles is the heart of the matter, so generational wealth. That's good. See what it says. See, that's the hermit there, old man. And there's the next gen. There's supposed to be three generations in this picture, the original one anyway. Pretty sure this one's a seer. Kid, there's another family there. And then we got the Ace of Wands, which is like a passionate new beginning. Maybe inspired by, or gifted by the Divine. So you're going to be passionate about, the challenge is to be passionate about something. So in the subconscious we have no subconscious spirit for our Taurus. Subconsciously, you're thinking about working. You're working hard at your craft. Whatever you do. Spend your time. In the past, you moved on. You moved to somewhere else. You moved on to... sailed on to calmer waters. Or possibly not. That's what your intentions were. Move somewhere, possibly. We got in present is the Seven of Wands. So like defending against someone. But you got the high ground, so. But basically like just defending whatever it is you have. Queen of Wands is the outcome of this situation. There's a cat in there too. She got the wrong one. It looks like a candle. What do we got influencing the situation for our Tauruses? It's the main thing influencing. It's two. Ace of Cups. So, new love offer and betrayal. And fears. Hopes and fears for our Tauruses. playing something over and over in your head. And what's the environment? This one? Strength. So that's Leo energy, strength, and the environment. And what's the outcome of this situation for our process? Magician of the desert. And judgment. Holy shit. Death and judgment in the same. Where's judgment? Okay, so we've got four energies. Ten pentacles. Six of Swords, Aquarius, two Aquarius, all right, Seven of Wands, Leo. Season Aries. Aries. And we got Ten of Swords. Gemini. Oh shit, we almost got a good video, don't we? Gemini. Ace of Cups. Nine of Pentacles. Virgo. So we got like triple Virgo so far, so let's hit you right now. Nine of Swords is Gemini. Yeah, we just did that one. Strength is Leo. So that's two Leo. We got Death and Scorpio. And Nine of Cups is Pisces. Okay, so we got like heavy Virgo and heavy Leo and heavy Pisces, basically. Everything else is just a little bit Scorpio, a little bit Gemini, a little bit of Aries. So, oh, what's that thinking? Yeah, that's better. Okay, so those are the signs in there. Let's see what it says about the, okay, so we got Heart of the Matter, we got the Ten of Pentacles. So, somehow you're getting shit on my ears. We got the Ace of Wands, which is the challenge that's like to be passionate about something. So, whatever you got it for, I guess it's passionate. Subconsciously, you're thinking about your work, so it might have been work related. The way you're making this for it. Six of Swords is moving, that's in the past. So, Seven of Wands, high ground, defending what you have. Queen of Wands is in the future. Let's see what it says about the Queen of Wands in this particular deck. No. Resolve, test of feet, stamina. Nine of ones. Nine of ones. Cool. Determined, charismatic, confident. Some may turn from this queen uncomfortable with her virile masculine sexuality. Is it really masculine, or is it just all such? Is it all just sexual energy? This queen hopes to inspire us all to express our sexuality with the same abandonment, enjoyment, and pride as men often do. If you don't, she won't care. She is busy living her life, wielding her power, seducing lovers, and being awesome. Well, there you go. That's nice. Ten of Swords. Let's see what says about that one. It's betrayal. I know that, but it's ultimate betrayal. Ruin, surrender, and giving up. When we are far away from the point where the land ends and the sea begins, appears. The line is less concrete the closer we get. The land curves under the sea, and the sea caresses the land. About ending beginnings. There is our endings. Although it isn't always clear, they were endings until you've gained some distance. Perspective is everything. Okay. Yeah, no shit. Ace of Cups. That could be a love offer. I want to see what else it says about them. They're a little different this one. I like the way they look. It's different. Ace of Cups. Love, grace, and creativity. Okay. Let's go with this one. Nine of Pentacles. Nine of Pentacles. Financial independence, self-efficiency, and achievement. Okay. Achievement. Oh, that's your hopes and fears. Your fears is like being in your head. So, strength is... see what I've got on the strength here. That's the energy. Strength. Courage and influence. Judgment and the Nine of Cups and the Page of Wands, death and judgment, transformation by judgment. And there's a Page of Wands involved here, so that could be the same as this Queen of Wands, so some kind of fire queen sending a page, possibly. It's going to bring some kind of judgment and death, well, transformation. It doesn't have to be a bad death, it could be a good one. I don't see a tower in there, which is kind of suspicious. But I want you guys to get a... that's about all there is here, really. But I want you guys to get a good look at what's going on. From the... underlying energy is poverty, actually. That's the next thing. So maybe somebody who's if you've got somebody's got 10 pentacles, or 10 pentacles is the heart of the matter, but the underlying energy is poverty. So, I don't know. Who has that 10 pentacles? It's at the end here, it says death, Nine of Cups, which is your wish is my command, and or wish will be granted. And, like, wealth, but not generational wealth, is what you start off with, so. Maybe somebody's going to try and snag something, or maybe you give something away. I don't know, you guys figure it out.